Last week's episode, we took a day trip down the coast to fish one of my favourite rivers. We got right up into the back reaches of the river, chasing some mangrove jack. Sit back and enjoy today's adventure with Unknown Road Adventures. All right, today we're heading up into the fresh water of the river. We're going to trek up over a number of rock bars. So it's pretty much an all-day trip. We go up on the high tide and we come back on the high tide late this afternoon. So come enjoy the adventures of today's trip. We picked a nice day to come up. The tide was dropping out fast, so I needed to get a move on to make it over the first few rock bars. As the morning went on, we reached the start of the fresh and the start of the rocks. Got to pull the boat through over the rock bars. This one's not the bad one. This one's a good one. We've got some shallow ones coming up. We're going up to this waterfall I found about 5 years ago. We've come to the first big rock bar. There's always time for a fish along the way. This is home to Australia's saltwater crocodile. Just because it's fresh water, it doesn't mean that they're not here. It's nice coming up into the fresh. It has a whole different feel about it.
After a quick break, it was time to push on and make our way up to the waterfall. The water's shallow. I need to be careful and take it easy. There's a small narrow channel running along the side of the bank. Check out the size of that bank. The water reaches the top of that in the wet season. It would be a sight to see.
What do you got?
I don't know.
I got some. Bring it in. Bring it in. Let me touch you. Bring it. Good boy. Over here. Swing it in. Swing it into me. There we go.
Got him.
Pop down with mummy. Get another one.
The fresh water up the Cape is home to some of Australia's native fish. The further we make it up the river, the narrower it gets. It's good to see the native lilies are flowering. Pitcher plants line the bank.
Good if we could get across it, high enough for us to get over it. It's normally a meter up. Yeah, this is where we have lunch. This is the spot.
We're getting closer to the waterfall. There's a nice little spot under the trees where we can have lunch. It's an awesome spot just to chill out for a while. Coops loves having a swim. Today is my birthday. What a top place to enjoy it. I normally leave the boat here and walk onto the waterfall. This year, the wet season is larger than normal, so with some help from Nick the cameraman, I pull the tinny across the high rock bar. This is the furthest I've brought my boat up this river. We've come to the end of the road. We're going to leave the boat here. It's only a short walk from here to the waterfall. We've finally reached the waterfall. The water has been carving out this landscape for thousands of years.
See it out there? It's called spot fishing.
I could see a couple of Saratoga swimming in the pristine water.
Oh, he's coming here again. Oh, look, there's big ones in there. A couple of Saratoga just followed my lure up there. Nice Saratoga, fresh water, up at the waterfall. What we got here is a freshwater Saratoga.
Yeah.
Beautiful looking fish.
Saratoga are poor eating fish due to their numerous fine bones. What an amazing place. We've had a good wet season this year and the water is higher than normal. Every year when I come to the Cape, this special day trip is always on the cards. Just hooked onto another Saratoga. Saratoga are an ancient fish and are one of the oldest on the planet. Saratoga grow to 1 meter and the bag limit is one per person. He's making a dash back into the deeper water. It was late in the afternoon and we had a long way to head back to camp. It was time to get a move on. What a great adventure coming up here with the family. Next week's episode, the family and I take the big boat out into the ocean, chasing some pelagics. And we head right in close, chasing after some queenies. Thanks for watching Unknown Road Adventures. We'll see you next time. Bye for now.